often the most important question to ask when looking at any new endeavor, is why. In this video, we'll answer the question, why COBie? No matter where you go in the world, taking ownership of a new building is a pretty exciting thing. But for the people that have to maintain and manage that building, this is often the experience that they have. That's because they can't use or can't find the information they need to run that building. So the facility manager takes the manuals out of the books and puts them up on the shelf. The problem is these aren't accessible to anybody out in the field, and the information that is needed is pulled out of the books and probably never returned. Of course, everyone listening to this video probably already knows that this is a problem. Here's a quote from the National Academy of Engineers in 1983. Since the 1980s, when everybody used MS-DOS and an early version of the cloud that you accessed with the dial-up modem, the design and construction industry has had an opportunity to transform the information delivered on paper documents into actionable facility and asset management information. Yet owners have not taken the initiative to decide what information is required when in the project in order to eliminate the costs of these very expensive documents. The cost of production of O&M manuals is just the beginning of the costs associated with the lack of actionable information available. The first cost encountered by most facility managers is the need to type the data back off of the paper and into information systems. Of course, each of the people that need the information have to keep their own set of records because there's no central repository. Let's take a look at the differences in data from this actual building. This facility management office had two separate databases, one maintained by the maintenance department and the other maintained by the asset management department. Please note that some of the information on this slide has been redacted since this is a real building. So this side-by-side report compares the number of rooms in each category of the maintenance system versus the asset management system. If we take the top three categories of rooms from the maintenance department, we can see that these are not the top three categories in the space management's database. Next, we can look at the number of spaces in each category and find out that these don't match. The second highest category of space management spaces is designated as not applicable. We can go further and compare all of the items in the maintenance department with all of the items in the space management department and see that they're wildly different numbers. There are even categories in the maintenance department and categories in the space management office's database that don't even match. Let's look at one specific room of the second floor of this hospital just to see what the practical result of such differences in data might be. Here's one example of the misclassification of just one small room in this building. It's behind the nurse's station in the middle of this wing. According to the facility management database used for providing keys to the building, this room was classified as a housekeeping room. In the space management database, this room was referred to as a medicine preparation closet. So I guess the real question is, who has keys to the OxyContin? Of course, this is only one of many different kinds of examples of how facility managers need consistent and correct information about the operations of their buildings that could have been delivered by designers and builders. So a typical answer to the question of how do we solve this problem is just, we'll wait for the software companies to help us figure it out. And so people have bought a lot of expensive software and attended a lot of training in order to figure out how to use that software, only to have the electronic equivalent of the paper in the boiler room. So here's the archive of all of the buildings at this facility management office, and they're in the upper left-hand corner of a shoebox in a cubicle of a guy that's retired, and so no one actually knows where any of the information is. Rather than rely on technology, people simply got together and said, what information do we need to run our facilities? And they developed COBie. COBie is the Construction Operations Building Information Exchange. You can think of COBie as a specification for all of the spaces and equipment in a building. COBie is an information exchange format. There's a specification for the assets and the equipment, as well as the way that that information should be exchanged. Specific owners may have specific requirements, and these can all be included in the specification for design and construction contracts. So the reason behind COBie is pretty simple. It's to reduce or eliminate the cost of construction handover documentation and improve the quality of that information so that it can be used effectively by the facility manager. I hope that this video has provided you some insight about why COBie might be helpful for your projects. Thanks for your time today.